You go play for kicks, you get a turnover chain, whatever you want to do. You know, everybody thinks it's magic. It's just belief, baby.
This cute little underdog story now has a very credible bite.
When he walks into a room, he won't soon be forgotten.
Who brings the juice?
I'm bringing the juice.
McCutcheon, triple threat. Yeah, there we go. This is pre-K through babysitting.
You guys are luck.
This is somebody that has unbelievable energy and passion.
You know who puts in the work? Everybody! Everybody puts in the work!
I hate losing. That was what was so frustrating, because now we have to try and figure out how to get out of this hole.
We're going to find our gift of passion. I'm going to go in a lot of circles, but I'm always going to come right back to where I'm supposed to go.
It's definitely different.
And that's going to be our whole modus operandi here, is to make sure that we do everything with instincts, love, and trust. That's the formula to start. The hardest fight in your life is forcing yourself to change, to not accept what is, but to change for the better and fight
everything. That 3-point shot from TC is good!
You just love to see the excitement that's back in this program.
Yeah, right.
First winning record in 10 years. Most home wins in 14 years. Most conference wins in 18 years. We could go on and on and on.
He has school record 54 points on the night, and the Griffins found themselves in a 9-point hole with 12 minutes to go.
I firmly believe with all my heart, guys, one man does not beat him. And right now, that's all he's doing. He's playing for 4 out of 5 other guys, and that's okay.
It was multiple Griffins that answered with a 15-3 run.
Tyus, he connects, and Missouri Western has done it! A program-changing win!
The conference is showing us all.
And the students are storming the court!
That's how we secure the first winning season in a decade.
We are all on the same ride right now. You understand that? So everything that you do for this team is important to us. And that is a moment that you need to taste, and you need to savor, and you need to enjoy, and then you need to do it again on Tuesday.
Yes, sir.
And then you need to do it again on Saturday.
Yes, sir.
And then you need to do it again at the conference tournament.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Now, it doesn't stop with the moment, because what we were trying to make now is memories. You understand that? We're trying to make memories for this team, for this program, for a lifetime for you guys, because this team after this year, it will never be together again. This team came together. Guys went through suffering and turned that sacrifice into success. The finality of it hurts because it is final. There is an end to a season. I tell you, I'm so freaking proud of you, man. You rallied an entire city to get behind you, to believe in something bigger than basketball, to believe in you, to believe in a team, to believe in people that suffered and shared together. For that, you can never take that away from these seniors, from this group of men, from Jason, Bo, and Tyus. You can never take that away from them. But what they built, and the only way you honor the past, is to make sure that our tradition never graduates. Our tradition, the people in this locker room, you never graduate here. You stay in this locker room. Your heart and soul stay in this locker room forever. And you will always be remembered, because not for how you played, but for what you gave.
With the second pick in the 2018 NBA Draft, the Sacramento Kings select Marvin Bagley III.
Man, I mean, he's a big part of like my development as a player. He definitely challenged me to be, you know, push me outside of my comfort zone. And he's gonna push you past your limits. And it might be tough at times, but you know, it's just a matter of getting past that. That'll be a smart decision to go play for coach.
66.
You gotta play hard, you gotta play smart, but you also gotta coach smart. And for me, I'll take this 100%. When we get in those rotations, we let 22 get two wide open threes on rotations. I wasn't clear enough, so that's completely on me as a coach. Our guys, they couldn't have played any harder. They couldn't have done any more to get back in this game and give themselves a chance to win it. So it's not their fault. We just erased the board again. So we're 0-0 again. I mean, it really sounds stupid because I know it's coach talk. And then go into Washburn and try to go 1-0. This culture is they're diving into it and they're having fun with each other. And the weight is off their shoulders because there's all this talk about, you know, how you used to be at home. And now you're 5-0 at home. It flipped from one win last year in conference to 5-0 at home, to protecting your house, to build an identity of you protect Looney. That's what you do. And when guys start to believe in something that's bigger than themselves, great things happen.
So that's a little bit more than
but we're 1-0.
We're 1-0. We're 1-0, but now we're 5-0. Well, if you collect a bunch of 1-0s, Ryan, that becomes 5-0. You know, I'm sorry you're not good at math, but crap.
Hey, Bobby, you're number 3. That's a horrible number, Bobby.
I'm okay with it if it's working. You know, when Jacoby Womack's got 16 points at halftime and you're talking trash to him, maybe just stop talking, you know, and find somebody else to pick on.
Hey, Christian, buddy!
Some guys like that stuff and they get it going, right? So you got to know which is the triggers. But I'm just excited that our fans are getting into the game. That's the type of stuff that I like. That's what Missouri Southern, I mean, their entire football team was literally 4 feet away from us. So maybe we should just start having our entire football team 4 feet away from everybody else because our football team's pretty good. A lot better than some other teams in this league last time I checked. You get fired.
I don't know where your source was, but it wasn't me.
So we fired our guys.
If I were to say, meet me in the locker room, would you be able to come in the locker room?
I'm not going to lie to you. We're not even allowed to step foot loony right now. But
I don't believe in luck. So don't wish me good luck. Now, there's some lucky things that happen in life. That's fine. I get it. I understand. My sister, who's a nun, Sister Joan of Arc, beat me on a half-court shot in the hill in Asheville in the windy with 30-mile-per-hour winds. She didn't think that was luck. She just said God's on her side. So, I get it. I was dead from the start, all right? P-I-G to nothing. Got it, all right? None on one. Griff up, baby, griff up. Yeah. This is like the wings of the eagle right here. Griff up right here.